actually told him, because he's an everyday sitting house, and my auntie's dad goes to see him.
Oh, you know, Russia's sister, right? Her house is near our house. Oh, it's like 3 minutes away from our house.
Okay, and Russia would stay with
me. And Russia's dad is staying with me. My niece, yeah.
Hello.
Because today's was the last
one.
She's trying to get fat, but she can't.
My name is Dina Akeel. I work at GASPI at the University of Science and Technology in the Museum of Science and Technology in I'm finishing my master's in creative media and education. And today I'm here because I'm presenting some of the research that I've done. So I just want to share it with the teachers. Most of my work was my targeted audience. My work were the children between 4 to 8 years old. So most of the activities or programs that I developed or presented were for that age. I'm here for today because I want to present three different parts in collaboration and education. So the main theme of the presentation today is collaboration and education. I'm going to display three things about collaboration between students, collaboration between students and teachers, collaboration between teachers and different educational sectors like media channels, museums, any education sector or any organization that's involved in the field of education. Any questions before I start? I'm just trying to change the slides from the back. As a beginning, what do you see in this picture?
Kids.
Yeah. The sculpture there, does it show anything? Community, yes, that's right. I'll tell you a small story. Once we had like around 30 children in one of the rooms, in the activity rooms in the museum, and we told them, let's work together so we can build a community. All of the kids were just terrified what community or maybe it's a big word to them. So when we told them what are the things that you find in the town that you're living, so they started to develop different things we need, like a house, hospitals, schools, supermarket, playground. And then we gave them recycled materials, so they started to work on it together, and then we make a very big community. So this was one part of the activities. The kids really enjoyed it. Blue was everywhere on the ground, on their clothes and their hands. And this was one of the start points that we started to do the different creative activities from the very simple materials. Okay, if I ask you a general question, what is collaboration? Collaboration is working together. It is like when you have two or more working together, working with each other to finish a task or to achieve a goal. I'm just going to give you different statements or things about collaborative learning. Collaborative learning is any learning where two or more students, they start to work together on an experience. If maybe they were playing a game, learning new things, practicing to play on a bicycle. And this collaboration would be successful if each one of the team succeed and learn what's his role and responsibility and what they can do together as a team. For example, if I wanted the children to paint a picture that or a paper that has like sun and three. So if the three kids, they started to throw a ball, so we didn't achieve the goal of having different pictures. Collaboration and education can take very different forms. It depends on the group age and the number of the students and the students' needs. What do they need to learn? So these are different things that I've used in my different parts of research. As I said, there are many different forms in collaboration. Collaboration can assist communities to grow in different regions. For example, in one of my researches, I had this big question. I asked the children between 4 to 8 years old, what do you know about Saudi Arabia? So they were just saying different things. We know that Jeddah, we know that we have a big Red Sea Mall. They told me, what do you know about the heritage of Saudi Arabia or about the things in Saudi Arabia or countries? They just named like maybe 2 or 3 countries. And when I asked them something about the United States, they would give me different facilities, names of countries. So this is the thing that started made me start this point to think about collaborating between, like, for example, a museum is a heritage place that we have a lot of information about science, history, and, for example, the heritage about Saudi Arabia or Muslim scientists. So how can we deliver this to different students? What do you think? How can we just transfer our information if we have a small case?
I think kids learn more through
stories
and fun activities. They don't like just learn just giving them all the information. They won't get it, especially like if you're saying from age 3 to 6. I think that's like the main thing that they will learn throughout the day. And other thing is if you can show them show anime or like a small video or anything that can show them anything in the past and in the future, kind of comparison.
That's right. Well, we tried, for example, to take them through different exhibits and they were just looking, enjoying the pictures. And because we have like scientific content with some history, they didn't understand. But when we just simplify the material to them, they understand it more easily. So at that stage, I started thinking of collaborating with different sectors. Once we had children from a special needs center, from the help center, and it was very difficult for my team and for me a bit. So how can we deal with them? What can we do in the museum with them? So
I'm sorry to interrupt you. I just wanted to know what kind of special needs you want to have.
They were Down syndrome.
Oh, wow.
Down syndrome.
Okay, so they do have that.
Yes, they have.
So they're not kind of autistic or anything like that. Because I was thinking, it's like very interesting to me to know how can you deal with a kid that you have a certain condition, especially like if they're autistic and like your subject is about collaboration. So how could you guide those autistic children to be in your team?
I'm gonna answer your question in a while because I present some pictures. Okay. It's on Down syndrome. Thank you for this question because it was one of the questions that were very highlighted in one of my research when I worked with the Down syndrome students and learning disabilities. One thing that I've noticed in most of my research was that kids are very, very, very honest in their opinion. So if you show them something, they will tell you that, no, I don't like it. I hate it, this is beautiful, this is bad, that's difficult. So this is the thing that helped me in developing some of the programs. As I mentioned before, I'm going to now say different things about collaboration in education. So how we can have kinds of collaboration between teachers and students, how we can have kinds of collaboration between the students and between the teachers and different educational sectors. Any questions to that? Yes. Okay. As I mentioned, that they are very honest in their opinions,
And they, whenever you give them the opportunity to give you some ideas, they are very, very creative in the ideas that they would give you and the opinions that they have. So now I'm going to present the three different models. First, the collaboration between teachers and students. I'm going to present two pictures about children here. We gave them a map and we told them just try to draw a different route if you wanted to travel from Saudi Arabia to a different country. So where do you think the direction is? Because at that age they don't have geography or they don't learn geography. But you can teach them about different lands in the world. So they started to ask different questions. We were working with them like individually, not in groups. Maybe we just had them on different tables and routes. And then they had very creative routes. One of them, she said that she wants to travel from Saudi Arabia. She wants to go to the United States, then to Malaysia, and then she wants to go to South Africa. So imagine what would the airplane route would be, or how many days she would take to travel in such a trip. And this was also one of the individual learning that we collaborate with the students. Most of the students here are not Arabic speakers, and they don't know Arabic very well. And at that time, we were talking to them about Arabic calligraphy and how you can write different letters and you can design something with that. So we gave them shapes of different animals, like a tiger or a lion, and they traced the shape. And then we started to display different letters to them. We started to use these letters to write them and to fill in the trace part, so they had their own design. At that time, the Arabic speaker students or the Arab students, when they finished, because they know the letters easily, they're more familiar to the letters, they started to help the other students. And we finished in like half of the time that we planned for this activity. But from the results, we had a very good